Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. This is Asad Yaqub, and in this video, I am going to give you some useful tips and techniques for your IELTS listening test. I have been teaching IELTS for a long, long time. If I tell you exact number of years, then you will start guessing my age. So I'm not gonna tell you. Anyways, over this time, I learned a lot about IELTS. I solved various tests, listening tests, reading tests. I've been through writing tests, speaking tests, and now I can say I know IELTS inside out. Okay, so I'm going to share some tips, and you might have seen my videos, detailed videos on IELTS listening, reading, writing and all that, and then you can see how well I try to explain. Anyways, as far as IELTS listening is concerned, these are the tips which will help you on exam day or any other day when you take IELTS listening practice test at home. First of all, whenever you take the listening test, you should use pencil on the question booklet. So adopt a habit that you have a pencil and you just use pencil on question booklet and get used to it, because when you were small, you used to use pencils as well, right? So the first thing is use pencil. Second, as the audio starts, when they say you're going to listen to a conversation between a house renting agency and a student who want to rent a room, so you should imagine whatever they say in listening. Number one, imagine that. Your imagination will actually help you understand the audio. Most of the time, students complain that we don't actually pay attention, or we cannot pay attention to the audios in listening. Sometimes we are doing listening, but our mind goes here and here and all that. That only happens when you don't imagine what you listen. So it's a very good idea to imagine, to switch on your imagination as you are listening, because through your imagination, you will be able to penetrate or dive deeper into that audio, and then even your guesses are going to be right as well. As the test starts, just go on. I mean, when they give you half minute to read the questions, only read the portion where there are the questions. Like question number one, then there will be some information. Then question number two, there will be some information. So with that extra information, just underline any word. For example, the word can be 27. The word can be black. The word can be bag or anything like that. Just underline so that you know the audio has reached here. Right? And when the answer comes, write your answer. And by the way, if you make any mistake at the same time, do not use eraser. When I conduct mock test here in Lahore, I see many students during their IELTS test, they are erasing and then trying to write again. The audio will go. I mean, your connection with the audio is like you're holding something, like you're holding a rope. And if you leave it, it will let go. It will go out of your hand. So you're not supposed to leave that contact with the audio, right? So therefore, if you make a mistake, cross that word, write it again. Okay, so in listening part one, you should try to get 10 out of 10. Let me tell you, listening part one is very basic, very simple, very easy. And if you get 10 out of 10 in listening part one, this thing will help you, or this thing will enable you to achieve more band when you're going to score in part 2, 3 and 4, right? Now, at the end of each part, they give you half minute to check your answers, and there is hardly any answer that you need to check. Therefore, I advise you to take this time and immediately jump to part 2. Now you can come to part 2. I asked one of the invigilators who is working for any IELTS, for one IELTS examination body, and he said, we don't say anything to the students. If they want to move to part 2, they can move anytime. So just move to part 2. Now half minute to check your answers and half minute to read the questions. You will have more time. Let me tell you, understanding the question is 50% of your IELTS listening. And then understanding the audio is another 50%. So if you don't understand the question, you will not find the answer. And if you understand the question and you don't understand the audio, again, you will not find the answer. So spend more time reading the question. And one more thing, make yourselves familiar with IELTS listening and all the question types, and don't create any enmity against any question type like maps. I hate maps. I dislike maps. Multiple choice questions. I really hate multiple choice questions. I don't like. Don't create any feeling of anxiety, feeling of nervousness, feeling of failure that in maps I can never answer any question. In multiple choice, I'm always wrong. In this question type, I can only find one answer correctly out of five. Never develop anything. Okay, just try to love IELTS. Multiple choice. I like multiple choice very much. Maps. Oh, maps is, I love maps very much. They are very close to my heart. Right? Something like that. Okay? Because you know, if you develop any negative feeling, one of my students, she failed to achieve her desired band because she had developed this feeling of dislikeness with maps. She said, I don't like maps. I cannot do maps. I don't even understand maps. Maps are so confusing. When she went to take her IELTS test, she turned the page part 2. There was a map waiting for her and she looked at the map and she said, oh my God, I'm gonna fail this test. So don't develop any feeling like that. One more thing, deal with IELTS listening section by section and watch your progress in each section. Like you say, now in section 1, I'm getting 9 to 10 correct answers. Now in section 2, my right answers are 7 or 8. Now in section 2, I'm only getting 4 correct answers. So I have to work hard with section 3 or part 3. So this is how you can measure your progress. You can gauge your progress and all that. Next, as far as IELTS listening is concerned, we do have multiple choice. I have made videos. I have my study plan. All these things will help you. Let me tell you about part 4 IELTS listening. In part 4, they give you 1 minute to read the questions. What do the students do? They try to read everything which is on that page from questions 31 to 40. Let me tell you, just read the points where there is the question. Like question number 31, read that point. After that, there will be 2 to 3 notes. Don't read them, but underline important words. If there is any proper noun, any date, any time, any number, underline those and then come to question number 32 and see what is written before the blank and after the blank. So that is really going to help you. In the same way, questions 33, 34, and one more thing. Whenever in IELTS, listening, you have one word only, because most of the time in part 1 and part 4, you get one word only. So guys, make it a habit, never write article, and the, some, never write article. Number 2, never write any extra word. If it is one word only, don't write any extra word. If it is multiple choice A, B, C, for example, A 1950, B 1960, C 1970, answer is C, and instead of C, with C you write 1970, your answer will be wrong. So don't try to give extra information. I'm trying to make the job of examiner easier by providing all the details, and the same examiner is going to ditch you by giving all this information. So be careful about all these things, right? I mean, along with your English language, along with understanding of the audio, there is something which is what we call common sense. I will call it IELTS common sense. And through this video, I tried to develop that very common sense. Take test after test, measure your performance, see whether you are improving or your band score is decreasing test after test. So if it is decreasing, focus each section, see your performance in the question type, follow my videos, my study plan, and most definitely these things are going to be easier. If you're looking for 7 band, try to make 34, 33 correct answers randomly in the tests. Okay, then in actual exam, you will get your desired band. If your desired band is 8, for that you need 34 correct answers. So you should try to get randomly 36, 37 correct answers. Because in actual exam, if the test is more difficult, so at least you would be able to score 34 to achieve 8 band. right? Yeah, exactly. So that's all, guys. Thank you very much. I always try to give you the tips and techniques, everything from my heart to your heart, without any hindrance, without any obstacle, without any break, because I believe sharing is caring, and I literally care for you. All the best. I also teach IELTS online all over the world and on campus here in Lahore. If you want to be the part of my online or on campus IELTS classes, my WhatsApp number is given. You can contact me for that. Asad Yaqub truly wishes you all the best. Take care. Allah Hafiz.